Hightstown High School Wind Ensemble join us. And we all know what a wonderful program they always bring with them. And I can see that their reputation has grown because the room is getting more and more crowded with each concert they bring. But I still see that the residents still sit in the back and the parents still sit in the front. But in any event, we are delighted that they are here. So let's give a warm Meadow Lakes welcome to Mr. Seth Davis of the Hightstown.
Saucedo's Ukrainian bell carol, which is his really exciting and masterful take on the famous Christmas carol. And if you really listened in there, you could hear a little bit of jingle bells too. Did we hear that? Awesome. Good. So they're doing their job. Awesome. Now, the next piece that you're going to hear has a lot of little musical messages in it too. Robert Palmer's Overture on a Southern Hymn is a really incredible piece that bases off of a super old hymn called Wondrous Love. Okay, and this was from a book called Southern Harmony, which is written by William Walker in the mid-1800s, and it's from shape note music, which basically is really, really, really old church music that has absolutely no words, and after their services, they would spend singing basically wordless melodies for hours. And this is a really famous melody that is very often actually sung in church now. And what Palmer does is he takes this melody, he introduces it to us about 30 seconds in, and then he has his way with it. He basically puts it into three really crazy and virtuosic variations, and then he has a really exciting finale that all contain little snippets of this theme. So to help you out, and so you can kind of track your way through this, because I know sometimes it's hard to hear the way the themes are moved around because the composer gets really convoluted in his interpretation, which is a good thing and a bad thing. We're going to have our principal flute player, Miriam, just play the hymn so you can hear it, so when we're listening, we're all on the same page, okay?
Thank you.
Nice job, Miriam. Okay, so here is Overture on a Southern Inn.
Thank you. So next, our next number is a set of Christmas carols from the Victorian era. Okay, the first piece you're going to hear is the First Noel, which is pretty standard and run-of-the-mill, but it's a really nice setting of it. The second is a lesser-known carol called Coventry Carol, which actually has kind of a dark background if you look into the translation of the text, but it's pretty here. And the third movement is Angels We Have Heard on High. Okay, this is a really nice arrangement of three carols, so tis the season, so hope you enjoy the three Charles Dickens Christmas carols.
Thank you. microphone. We can't hear you.
Good, thank you. So our next number is on the other side of things. This is an arrangement of a bunch of Hebrew folk tunes by Philip Sparke, who's a really well-known British arranger, both for wind ensemble and for British brass bands. And this piece is the second movement of his suite called Shalom, which is basically a collection of a bunch of different songs that are both Israeli and from the liturgy of different types of Jewish services. So this is a really interesting take. One thing I want you to listen for, obviously, in addition to the beautiful melodies of the folk songs, is what Philip Sparke does in the background. He's really, really good at making the players who are normally given parts that are usually a little boring, or they tend to sustain on one note for a really long time. He tends to give them parts that are much more interesting. So once you hear the melody, I want you to kind of take a second to listen to everything that's going on behind it. Because what he does is he really makes the melody come alive with what's called the accompaniment, which is basically what makes the melody sound good. Okay? So here's it's the second movement of Philip Sparke's Shalom.
Thank you.
final piece for this evening is a doozy. So 200 BC was written, I'm going to get to a cool place. Okay. 200 BC was written by Gregory Rudgers about 12 years ago, and it's truly an undertaking. Now, this piece is taken from material written before, you know, AD, hence the title 200 BC, from something called the First Delphic Hymn, and it is music that is not only taken from really, really early times, but it also covers early subject matter. What the composer tries to do here, basically, is tell the story of what happens in the Odyssey, but from what happens at home in Ithaca, as opposed to what happens when Homer is on all of his exciting journeys. Okay, and he uses these two themes from the Delphic Hymn to sort of tell that story. So we're going to hear those in just a second. But what I want to do first is sort of take you through the four movements so you know what to listen for. The first movement, which is called the Entrada, is basically like a grandiose introduction of both the themes and the characters. Okay, and the main two characters here are Telemachos and Homer. And this introduces Homer. It's big, it's heroic, it basically shows the grandeur of his kingdom. The second movement is a depiction of Telemachos, who is Homer's son, as he defends his kingdom. So there's a lot of confidence, but there's also a lot of weakness there. And the melody that you hear, the four-note motif, which you'll hear in a second, is basically what makes up that melody. The third movement, everything just crumbles apart. It almost gets destroyed. And that's where a bunch of noblemen come in, because Homer's gone for a long time. They come in, and they basically trash the kingdom. And to depict that, what Rudgers does is he puts the music in 5/8 meter, which is very irregular and almost uncomfortable to listen to, and he stacks the notes that were originally all together in a melody, he stacks them on top of each other in a chord, so it sounds really harsh and super dissonant. So you'll hear that in the third movement. And the fourth movement, Homer comes home, everything's happy, the two themes sort of come together to be a single melody, and that's how 200 BC finishes out. So what we're going to do is we're going to play the first two measures of the first movement separately. The first part of the first movement is the four-note motif, and that's what you're going to hear pretty much continuously throughout the whole piece. What you'll hear more sparingly is the second thing, which is the fanfare theme, and that's basically just to represent the city of Ithaca and its strength. But the more prominent thing is the first. So here's the four-note motif. It all boils down to that in 8 or so minutes. So I hope you enjoy. This is Gregory Rudgers' Epic 200 BC. Thank you. Do you want to hear one more?
Sure.
Good. We're prepared this time. We're always prepared. This is the first time. So the encore we're going to do for you tonight is a really, really super cool piece. Probably my favorite band related. Hi, Alex. My favorite band related Christmas piece ever. And this was written by or arranged by Sammy Nestico, who do we know the Count Basie band? Yeah, awesome, awesome group. Nestico was one of the arrangers for that group for, actually he still is, he's still alive, for a very long time. He also wrote for over 70 television shows between like the mid-50s and like the early 70s, like Mission Impossible. He's just been everywhere. And fortunately, he's graced his presence in writing a lot of really great jazz-related band arrangements that actually sound good and don't sound like jazz in a can. And this is a really cool arrangement of Good Swing Wenceslas. So we hope this piece takes you into a swinging holiday season. We're happy to be here. This is one of our favorite events of the year. And I hope you enjoy Good Swing Wenceslas.
Thank you.
thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having us, and I hope you have a great holiday season. Have a good night.